Okay, so for today's video, we're going to be taking a look at multiplying mixed numbers. So when we've got a question where we're going to multiply mixed numbers, what we're actually going to do first is convert them into improper fractions. Once we've done that, we can treat this like a normal multiplying fractions question, where we just multiply the numerators together and then the denominators together. Once we've done that, we can then simplify and turn back into a mixed number. So for this first question, I've got 2.5 multiplied by 1¾. So to start with, we're going to turn these mixed numbers into improper fractions. So the way we do that is we take the denominator of the fraction part, we multiply it by the whole number part, and then we add on the numerator of the fraction. So for this first fraction, the denominator will be the same, so it's still going to be over 2, but I do 2 multiplied by 2, which is 4, add on the 1, gives me 5. So 2.5 is the same as 5 over 2, we're then multiplying that by this 1¾. So I'm going to change that into an improper fraction. So again, the denominator is still going to be 4, but then to find the numerator, I'm going to multiply the 4 by the 1 to give me 4. I'll then add on the 3, which will give me 7. So this fraction here would be 7 over 4. So now we're just going to multiply the fractions together. So we did the numerators multiplied together. So 5 times 7 would give us 35. And then 2 multiplied by 4 would give us 8. So we're going to check if we can simplify that first. Well, we can't because 35 over 8 is in its simplest form. So then we just convert into a mixed number. So we want to see how many times does 8 fit into 35? Well, 8 will fit into 35 4 whole times, because 4 times 8 is 32, leaving us with the remainder of 3. So the remaining part here will be 3 over 8. So 2.5 multiplied by 1¾ is equal to 4 3/8. Okay, we've got some more questions to have a go at now. If you want to have a go at these first, feel free to pause the video here, and we'll go through the solutions in just a few moments. So for these questions here, we've got to give them as fully simplified mixed numbers. So for this first question, I've got 1⅓ multiplied by 3⅕. So again, just like we did with our other questions, we're going to change these into improper fractions first. So for my first fraction, it's still going to be out of 3. But then I do 3 multiplied by the whole number part. So 3 times 1 is 3. Add on the 1, which gives us 4. So that would be equivalent to 4 over 3. We're then multiplying that by, well, this improper fraction is going to be over 5. So then to find the numerator, I do 5 of the fraction part, multiply that by the whole number part. So 5 times 3 is 15. Add on the 1 is 16. So now what we're going to do is multiply these fractions together. So for the numerators, I do 4 times 16, which gives us 64. And then for the denominator, we'd have 3 times 5, which gives us 15. So 64 over 15 is in its simplest form. So now we're just going to convert it into a mixed number. So we want to see how many times does 15 go into 64? Well, it will go in 4 times, because 4 times 15 is 60, leaving us with a remainder of 4. So the remaining fraction would be 4 over 15. So that would be our answer for that one. For our next question, we've got 2¾ multiplied by 2⅓. So again, I'm going to do exactly the same for this one. I'm going to change these mixed numbers into improper fractions and then multiply them together. So for this first fraction, it's still going to be out of 4. So then to find the numerator, I'm going to do the 4, multiply it by the 2, which gives me 8. Then add on the 3, which gives me 11. And then multiplying this by, well, the denominator is still going to be 3. Then to find the numerator, we do 3 multiplied by 2, which is 6. Add on the 1, which gives us 7. So we've now got 11 over 4 multiplied by 7 over 3. So multiplying the numerators together, we've got 11 times 7, which is just 77. And then for the denominators, we've got 4 times 3, which is 12. So this is equivalent to 77 over 12. We can't simplify that any further, so now we're just going to change it into our mixed number. We want to see how many times 12 fits into 77. Well, it fits in fully 6 times, because 6 times 12 is 72, which would leave us with the remainder of 5. So our fraction part here would be 5 over 12. So our answer to this one would be 6 and 5 over 12. Okay, for this next one, we've got a mixed number multiplied by a proper fraction. Again, we're still going to do the same thing. We're going to change our mixed number into an improper fraction, which then we can multiply by the proper fraction. So I'm going to change this 1½ into an improper fraction, so we know it's going to be over 2. So then we do 2 times 1, which is 2. Add on the 1 gives us 3. So now I've got 3 over 2 multiplied by, and then the proper fraction I can leave as it is. So that's going to stay as 5 over 7. So now what I'm going to do is multiply these fractions through. So the numerators first, we've got 3 times 5, which is 15. And then for the denominators, we've got 2 times 7, which is 14. So that's equivalent to 15 over 14. We can't simplify that any further. So our final step here would be to turn that into a mixed number. We want to see how many times does 14 fit into 15. Well, it fits in one whole time with a remainder of 1. So our fraction part here would be 1 over 14. So well done if you followed along with those questions. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are at all any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.